So this is a demo of the right-hand side trees. And what we are going for is a general or a gradual transition from unsaturated and light to saturated and brighter and a little darker. There'll be some highlights up here. We have a darker color and a more vibrant color because we use phthalo blue to mix this one. And then we use cerulean blue to mix this one. How you choose to mix your colors and what you use in here, you have some freedom with. As long as it is light, so mixed with quite a bit white and unsaturated, and a bit fuzzy back here, things get crisper and darker and more intensely saturated as you come forward in space. So right now, we're just gonna be working on this right side. If you have an underpainting already done in that area, fantastic. If not, you can just skip the underpainting and go straight to what we are doing right now. I want to show you what an underpainting looks like. This was video 3 from our previous lesson. And if you did that, this is what it would look like. So it's a kind of practice of going from light to darker. This has only the value change. It doesn't have the color change as well. So practicing and doing that first could be helpful. And if you want to do that, you would do that by mixing phthalo blue, and you want to unsaturate that by mixing orange, because orange is opposite of phthalo. You get orange by mixing these two. So you'd unsaturate phthalo blue to go this direction and make that value. So if you want to, you can. The video for that is video number 3. This is now video number 5, actually, because video number 4 was showing you how to mix these two. All right, so I'm gonna leave this here, and my paint palette I'm gonna show you guys occasionally. I'm gonna put this one right here so it's visible in the screen as well, where we're kind of going for. And I'll just be holding up my paint palette this way, so I'm gonna show how to load the brushes. So we're gonna start with and use mostly the filbert brushes. You guys should have 2 filbert brushes, a small one and a large one. So filbert are the ones that are rounded on the top. It's easier to see that this one's rounded on the top because it's a bit larger. This one is a filbert, but it is a bit smaller. Okay. All right, I'm gonna go with the large first because we wanna get kind of block out the areas that we're gonna be working on. You just set that down over there. Okay. We have the sketching in the background. So we can tell this is the lighter space, this is the medium space, and this is the dark space. So I'm gonna start with the light here. And you need to mix some more blue with that. And here, and quite often today, we're gonna be mixing our colors on our palette here. And notice that when I'm mixing, I'm not thoroughly mixing the color. And that's okay, because the more variation in color that we have with a technique like this, the cooler it's gonna look. So I'm gonna take some of that, and I'm deciding to have a little bit more green. If you want things to be a little bit more blue, you can do that too. But I like this color. I think that's super pretty. You guys do have your green down here that you could unsaturate and lighten and use. You've got all these different blues as well. I'm gonna take some blue . I just added some blue off to the side here. And while this is still here, I'm gonna use my smaller brush to mix in some white to lighten that up, because it is still definitely not light enough yet. The technique that we're trying to match here is like all sorts of dabs of paint. That's why I didn't thoroughly mix my paint to begin with. It's why I'm kind of like dabbing on here and mixing the paint a little bit on here as I go. So it's quite a bit of a different process than something that we've tried before. This is also the final version of this area. I'm trying to get it to look perfect right now before I do anything else. I do want some sky blue in there. And I think I want some of that original sky blue to show. So that's just kind of the edge. I'm gonna make it a lot lighter though. So you can see how thick that paint is. If I were to take a brush and just go over the whole thing and smooth it out, it would drastically change the look of it. If I wait about 3 minutes, wait for the paint to dry a little bit, and then smooth it out, then it's only gonna take some of the paint that is wet and move it, but the rest of the paint that's dry is gonna stay there. So that's a technique that I want to demonstrate to you guys. It is a bit more of an advanced technique because you have to pay attention to how things are drying and catch it at just the right phase. Oh, I picked up a little bit of yellow on my brush. Well, I'm just gonna go with it and take some of that yellow and bring it down. I'm just applying some of this more white in there. And I'm only doing this one section because I am gonna try and control the dryness level and show you that technique of blending it a little bit when it's semi-dry. So I have a large bristle brush and these will be located up front if you want to try this technique. Again, you can leave it just like this or you can try this technique that I'm gonna show. This technique involved a light touch. And it just kind of fuzzes everything just a little bit. And that's really good for things in the distance that are far away that we want to be a little fuzzy. Super, super light pressure here. And I'm pulling up and down and sideways. Because I don't want the brush strokes to stay visible. I'm just trying to like gracefully grab the wet paint that's on top and move it just a little bit. Okay. See how that's a little bit more fuzzy now? Okay. This side I'm just gonna fuzz out too because I don't want a crispy edge there. As I'm looking at this, I'm noticing that there's a few areas that are still crispy, like right in there. This is the part that's far back and we don't want that intense level of crispiness there. So I'm just gonna cover that up just a little bit. And on my palette here, because I've left some of this other paint there, I can go in and just grab a little bit of that and start to kind of dab that in just a little bit. I kind of enjoyed this yellow that came through there, so I decided to add just a little bit of yellow in some places there. Pulling it out just a little bit. If you try and pull the paint with this brush when there's only one layer of paint, it's not gonna work because it's gonna dry too fast. In that area, I had multiple layers that I kept adding and kept adding, and then I let it dry, use this brush to kind of pull it apart. All right, I wanna continue showing the rest of this section before you paint because we will be utilizing these colors for that. And this entire right section, when we're done with this portion of the demo, mine will be finished, and then you guys will go paint yours, and then yours will be finished. So looking at this section here, this middle section, is the next kind of darker area. So in my mind, I need to think about what sort of greens that I want. And I could choose this green that was made with phthalo, or this one that was made with cerulean. I could even use some of the phthalo that is right here and use some of that too. I don't want you to use phthalo green by itself. Mix it with something else, even a little bit. like what I did right there. So that's a new color that I mixed. So don't use phthalo by itself. Mix it with something else, even if it's just a little bit of something else. And I do want to unsaturate that a tiny bit. So I just took a little bit of red to unsaturate. So now I have an unsaturated version of that new green that I mixed. And for this one, I'm gonna start here and work my way that way. And this is where you wanna start to pay attention to the texture marks that your brushes are making. Because this tree that's gonna live right up front here, it's gonna be crispy. It's gonna have texture. The things that are far away are blurred out. The ones that are up here have texture. So I'm gonna start with just a base layer of some texture that will be my tree. Gonna do some more unsaturated down towards the bottom. Gonna make this really obvious now here. That's unsaturated there. Okay. And this is my large brush. You can get quite a bit from using your large brush here. Gonna use some of this right here as well. And I know I'm gonna add some white to this too. You're just building up texture on top of texture. When I add the white to it, it'll brighten up and enliven a lot of those colors that are there. So notice when I'm brightening it in smaller sections like that. You don't want to brighten the whole thing because then you'll lose your depth. In fact, I'm going to go in and add a little bit more depth. The darker spaces, darken those up just a little bit more with my smaller filbert brush. I just take a dark value with my phthalo and this other phthalo green that I have. So it's just a darker version of that one. And try to make marks like with different parts of the brush you wouldn't normally think to use. Like I'm using the side of the brush and just putting it directly against there. You can use the tip of the brush. And if you push lightly, look at that shape that it made. That's kind of cool. That's not really where I want that shape, but I put it there because I wanted to be able to show you guys that. Okay. I'm gonna move on to this middle area here. I'm wanting to have like multiple colors on my brush at the same time. Sometimes it's nice to have two brushes and use two at the same time. So like this one would, there we go. This one can be my light brush and this one can be my dark brush. I'm gonna go ahead and demo that. It's another kind of process of doing art that a lot of artists will do. They'll have multiple brushes kind of going at the same time. So I'm gonna take my dark value here and add a little bit of that in. And then with my white one, blend that. I'm overlapping a little bit. We want a little bit of a fluffy edge. You guys are so quiet. I hope it's because you're mesmerized, not because you're bored. Just added some color down there. We'll be working on like the bottom trunk part later. Hey Riley, can you bring the white over to me, please? I need a little bit more white. So this type of applying paint is really about the mark that the brush makes and being really purposeful about the mark that is left behind. As I'm looking at this, this part back here is not bright enough. So I'm just gonna brighten that up a little bit more. Okay, so that is pretty good. Next step is to get some of our ground in there. And I want everybody to try this technique that I'm about to show. And once you try it, if you don't like it, then you're welcome to paint over it and then do something different, do a different technique. But I want everybody to at least try this technique. I just realized I need to blur this just a little bit more. Down here underneath. There we go. Okay. All right, so this tree here, it doesn't look exactly like a tree yet. We're gonna get some of the trunk in there and that's gonna help with that. And that's what the Mars Black is for. Just a tiny little drop of Mars Black. What we're gonna do is I just picked up a little bit along the side, okay? And you can look and see on the side what sort of mark that it would make. We want it to be a straight mark, okay? So I'm gonna make sure that it's filled along the entire side of the palette knife, okay? And we're gonna do something that's called a jelly roll. And this is something that Bob Ross talks quite a bit about and uses often in his painting. So to have a jelly roll, you want an area that's flat and even, okay? Then for the interest of your visuals, I'll just clear this off. Okay, then you come in here and you cut. You see that jelly roll that's along the tip there? Okay, that's called a jelly roll. It's even all the way from end to end, and I've scraped it from this even section that's there. You can do jelly rolls in whatever color paint you have. The process, again, is just to make it even, clean off your palette knife, scrape a bit of it off so that you have an even roll along there. And we are going to start to cut in some of the branches here. I'm gonna start right down the very bottom. Brush is in the way. Okay. So you start a little bit lower than what you're actually going to do. You just cut in a branch. See how easy and quick that was? It wasn't precise. I didn't paint it. I cut it in. And I just did one straight one and then a little bit of one coming off to the side. I think I'm going to do another one right in there. And I'm going to do some back here as well. If we look at this hill slope right here, it kind of slopes down. So this next one, I'm gonna be put there. My jelly roll is starting to dry out. I can tell because it's not as crispy as it once was. So I'm gonna just get myself a new jelly roll here. And I'm gonna add a little bit more of that. So those are just some of the black ones that come first. I'll do a little tiny one back there too. You do have the other side
as well. So if you want a jelly roll on that small side, then you can use the small side and maybe be more precise with that. So try both sides, the long one and the short one, and see which one you prefer. If we look at the branches that are back here, they're actually, or the tree trunks, they're actually not pure black. So if you put one in a place that you don't want, like I've done, I'm gonna show you how to fix that. Okay. Let me get it wet. Try and get as much of that paint off first as you can. Then with your rag, just dab it off. Now I let that one dry a little bit too much before I took it off. So if it's dried, it's gonna be impossible to do this with. You'll have to cover it up with other paint. So I've tried to get rid of that, did the best that I could. I'm gonna cover it up before I try and paint my new one. So I'm gonna mix a new color here for these trees in the background and for some of the highlights on those. I've got the black, I'm gonna mix some white to turn it into a gray. And if your black has dried out, just dip your palette knife in water and then it can like rehydrate and blend it back in. So now I've got a new jelly roll and I'm gonna add some of this new color. I'm gonna grab some white, make this even brighter. Got myself a new jelly roll there. And I brought a little bit of green in it because I thought, I might as well. I chose to have a lot of green there anyway. So bring that in. Just along the side of the black, and it'll look like there's a highlight along the side of the tree. Okay. Last thing is I wanna have some of these be thick, like this very front one. So I've got a white jelly roll along the side and I'm gonna apply it and move it to the right. Just a little bit. See that? Super small movement, but I'm just gonna thicken up some of these in a few places. This guy got to be a pretty big tree, so I'm actually gonna let that be a big tree there too. So just brightened it up in a few places. Now, looking at this, this part right here is really thick. It's too thick for that place. It doesn't look natural there. So I'm gonna try and scrape off some of it. Didn't work because it's dry. If it was wet, that would be a quick and easy thing to do. So instead, I'm gonna use my angle brush. Scrape some of that off. There we go. Now it's thin. So we've used angle brushes. We know that those make some nice straight lines. We can use those to help these lines be straight. If I want to pull that one up, I can use my angle brush and pull it up like that. I just grew it out a little bit. I just grew in another little branch sideways there, because I'm taking the paint that's already there and I'm moving it around with this brush. So with that is the demo of the right-hand side. So light to dark, light to dark. This is a bigger contrast, light to dark, than what I've done here. I still might brighten that up a little bit just so that there's more of a contrast between the lighter far away and then the darker close up. If you wanna add extra dimension and detail into the tree that's up here, similarly to what's done there, you may definitely do that. And now is the time that you would be choosing to do such things. So I'm just gonna do a little bit of light up here. Just to highlight the top just a little bit. I'm still paying attention to the brush strokes that I make. But that brightened it up a little bit now. I'll bring that down just a little bit. So it looks like this tree right here is in the front. There we go. Now I'm done. And it's your turn.